Hey guys, Sam here.
And Angela, and welcome to our channel.
It is finally time, although the last video we shot was a horrible, horrible cliffhanger of an ending. I still blame her for that one.
Not me.
But this is the video where we get to bring you guys along, give you a final tour of our off-grid power system, show you how everything operates, integrates, talk about what it will and won't run, and what else have I forgotten?
I don't know. Stick around and let's see.
Sounds good.
Here we are at our solar panels. We have 20 on the front and 20 on the back. We've had some questions about why, or did we choose to put them where they are and situated the way they are. On our property, we have a bunch of hay field, and then we have our little homestead part. So we've been trying to keep the solar panels within the homestead part and not mess with the hay production. And putting it one in front of the other like it is, when you look at it from the road, the front one kind of hides the back one, so it's not as busy looking by seeing two solar arrays. If you're new to us and you hadn't seen the other videos, we have talked all about these solar panels, how we built the arrays and everything. You can check for a link for the video below. As we're walking over to our storage shed, we wanted to show you that this is what is between the two solar arrays. When we look at some of the other angles that we've done the videos at, it's kind of hard to tell how far apart they are, but they're probably at least about 20 feet apart. That also allows it to not have any overlap and the front one shading the back one at all any time of year.
Welcome to our literal utility building. I thought that was cool. I said it in the other video and I liked it. All right, so what I've got behind me, this is our Lux power inverter. This is where the wires from the solar panel come in here. It then controls the amount of charging going to the batteries over here, and also controls the inversion of electricity and pushes it out to the house. So this is the brains of our operation. Here to the right is the BigBattery ETHOS. The top is a control box, and below it are three batteries. We've already done a detailed video on the installation, setup, tech specs, and everything for the inverter and their battery bank. There's a link to that down below if you want to get really technical. But basically, this is what really is running the house. So we live in a single-wide mobile home, not a lot of space for a family of four that live there, homeschool there, and sometimes run businesses out of it as well. So this is why we have it in a utility building. But this is actually really, really helpful for us because we have not only the real estate to install it to begin with, but the room to expand it, which we'll talk about in a little bit as far as how could we expand this system, but we definitely have the room for that out here as well. As far as how this system integrates and connects to our home, it's right here. We installed a Reliance Controls Pro-Tran transfer switch box into our home, which connects and interfaces with our home's breaker box. This is something we chose to do because, one, we had the luxury of, since we live in a single-wide mobile home, there are a low number of circuits total in this breaker box. So having the option for 10 circuits, or in our case, 8 110-volt circuits, one 240-volt circuit, meant that this was a perfect fit for our needs. As far as operations and integrations and flipping switches, honestly, we've not had to touch this at all since flipping our home to solar, with the exception of one time, but I'll let Angela talk about that a little bit later. The beauty of this transfer switch is if we find and we watch the smart app, which I do a lot, and our battery percentage is getting low, we've had a lot of rain and clouds, and we just know that we're not going to make it off grid, I don't have to worry about moving physical circuits or somehow feeding a critical loads panel. I just simply reach up here and flip a switch. I don't know what circuit that was, but it just went on grid. Let's fix that. I have my phone right here set up with screen recording, and what you are seeing is the Lux Power Inverters app. This is hands down probably the number one thing that's now consuming my cell phone's battery because I watch it all the time. You don't have to do anything with this, but it is a great source of information. We can see right now our solar panels are bringing in 2,279 watts. The battery is charging, topping off at 120 watts. Its state of charge is at 100%, which is great. And then down below that, our house is currently using 2,093 watts. This is what I love to watch. It's the new fun thing to do, because from here, I'm able to see and make sure things are performing well. I can also see our house's usage and think, what exactly is running that's so energy consumptive? Right now, it's our mini split. Our AC for the entire home is included in that 2,000 and something wattage. It also allows me, when we get towards the evenings or we get days of very low sun, bad weather, I can keep an eye on that battery bank. So my plan, as far as the battery gets really low and it's in the evening or we're going to have weather of clouds, what we'll do is flip some of these grids on grid as we need to. So that's a real life example of how I have been using and plan to use the Lux Power Inverters app for real time monitoring, and then as need be, switching our breakers and circuits on grid and off grid as we live.
Well, first of all, our inverter can run our whole entire property. It has enough output that it could run everything in our home and buildings and all that stuff. It is our battery bank is not really big enough to hold for long if we had like a rainy day or something like that to be able to run the big bank things. What are those things? It's our stove, our dryer, and our water heater. Again, it could run it. We don't want to worry about running it all day and then having our batteries go dead at night. On the first day of being off grid, I went about life as normal, and towards the evening, I did a load of dishes and had them in the dishwasher just running like normal. Well, it has a heated dry setting that we use, and as Sam's watching his app, he's like, "What is going on? It's using a lot of power." And so we realized that we can't really do dishes in the evening or at night. And if I do need to do that, then we just go over to the little panel and switch the dishwasher onto grid power. And then we have no issue. Again, the inverter and our battery bank and everything can run the dishwasher in the evening. We just don't want to worry about losing power at night when the battery banks aren't filling up anymore.
All right, so let's talk about ways that we can expand or add to this system. I pretty much maxed out our solar input, although we're only at 14,000 watts of solar and the inverter can handle 18,000. So I guess there's room to grow there, but we definitely capitalized on those cheap Facebook marketplace listings for new solar panels to get as many as we need, plus give us future proof down the road. For us, the area that we're going to focus on expanding and growing is with our battery bank. The inverter can do everything, no problem. Solar panels are plentiful. We just want to have more storage capacity. So on our sunny days where we get, up to 10 hours of sunlight throughout the day, we need to be able to capitalize and utilize that. And that means bigger battery banks for storage. That will also allow us to then take our large appliances, workshops, all that kind of stuff completely off grid. Once we have the bigger battery, we will feel more safe and comfortable knowing that, okay, yes, we've got some large demands here. The solar can pump it out, but on those cloudy days, the rainy days, and at night, we're not going to run the chance of going dead in the evening. The benefit of the ETHOS battery system is that we can easily purchase additional modules and wire them in to the same ETHOS control box and connect it up, and we're good to go. This is a modular design, so a modular system, and one that you can kind of baby step into as far as sizes and capacities. Probably the number one thing to mention along with that, though, is you don't want to wait so long that your batteries you already own have aged a little bit and started to degrade, and then mix in brand new batteries with it, because then you'll have inconsistencies in capacity, charges, and as far as what I understand, the new batteries then will only perform as good as the older batteries. So for us, that means we need to make a decision pretty quick. We'll see. I would like to expand the batteries, but again, cost is always a factor. At least with this system and the ETHOS batteries, we do have that option.
I'm really curious, how much are we saving with this?
Well, to be honest, we've only been running off grid for, 2 weeks, and our power company has yet to really give us updated data, so I don't yet know. But if I want to predict how much we're going to start saving on our power bill, I honestly expect it to lower by about 40%. Historically, looking at our power bill, our home uses 50%, but our workshops and our areas where we run our small businesses from also use about 50% of our total power usage. So that's why I'm thinking 40%. Thinking another 10% is our stove, water heater, clothes dryer, and our buildings are just the other 50. So it may not sound like a lot on camera, but 40% savings is a pretty good amount. And if we get to upgrade our battery bank sooner than later, that will just help us save even more. We'll be sure to do an updated video after X number of months of running, I guess, partially off-grid and actually be able to quote and show you graphs of energy usage and cost savings at that point. I think that just about covers everything as far as the tour. You took them through the solar panels.
I did.
And I toured them through our utility building.
And then we both did in the house.
Yeah.
So that kind of shows everything.
There you go. So if you followed us along with us for the installation of all this, you'll see it was a lot of work to do. But once everything is done and installed, as far as what we have to do hands-on, we honestly have not had to think about much of anything with it. There's been the occasional, hey, what's the battery percentage? Although I don't think you've ever asked me, because you know I watch it all the time.
Yeah.
Looking at the battery percentage and thinking this and that, but honestly, the lowest our batteries have gotten overnight, I believe, was around 40-something%. And that was the day that we had the dishwasher run late, and we were also using the heat with the mini split, which, interestingly enough, the heat seems to use more electricity than the AC version of the mini split. Don't know. But even with that, we still got through the night completely. We got back into daylight, and with our solar panels, the size that they are, honestly, our battery charges within the first couple of hours of the morning, which is great.
It is.
And even on rainy days, because we've had several rainy days, our solar array has still had no problem charging our battery back to capacity. So that would be a benefit of the oversized solar array, right? On a day like today, we're cooking and booking. It's crazy large.
It's complete.
Yeah, but on rainy days, cloudy days, it's so large that it still has the ability to run the house plus charge the batteries. And that's what you got to think about.
Well, guys, thanks for coming along and seeing our solar system. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Otherwise, we'll see you guys next time on the homestead.
See you guys.
Bye.
This is where I'm going to trust the camera. Oh, wait. Ooh, it's got it. Cool. Blink.
What's my question?
So in that instance, using the Lux Power Inverter app is hands... What am I trying to say?
We don't want to worry about running it all day and then having our batteries go dead at night.
People who saw the video is overkill. And we did it. Thanks. That's all. That's all, folks. The battery bank can run the dishwasher no problem. We're just avoiding the worst case scenario of power outage at night.
Okay.
Does this make you feel better?
A little bit.
I'm a bumbling idiot over here. What are you doing? Getting hit by something?
Yeah. It's crawling on my forehead.
You know, if you have a beard, you don't feel them at all.
No, that's
you
okay.
Consider it. Well, it's 2024. They had bearded ladies in, what, circuses back then?
Mm-hmm.
Could be an alternative income stream. What are we waiting for? Bless you. That's a little more disappointing in life than that, is.
What?
Just thinking of how rarely get to do that, and it works for.